gospel message. It is very, very simple. That Jesus Christ came, he died on the cross. That he was buried, he arose on the third day morning. And he is now seated at the right hand of God, making intercession for all of us that will call on his mighty name. Salvation is free. The word of God said it is a gift of God through Christ Jesus. You can have salvation, but it's only through Jesus. The world will have you to believe that there are many roads to God. You can be anything you want. You can create your own way. You can maybe think that, well, I'll be good.
Where are the morals that govern our lives? Someday
he'll do it for you, because that's where God's heart is. God loves you. That's the heart of God. God is love. And he doesn't want to give anybody up. He doesn't want to give any of them out. When he looks at you, he knows the circumstances of your life. But what he sees, when he looks into your eyes, God sees promise. God sees promise. He doesn't see failure. He sees promise. But he wants you to walk to the light. He is the light. He wants you to forsake all others, forsake the world, and come to the light. Won't you stand?
To live your life however you want to live it. That great God is talking to you this morning and wants you to make a change in your life. Because greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world.
I know the rock of all ages I will stand.
Through the changes of time.
The changes of time.
Just do whatever you want to do. But you can't do that. Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, he said, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom. And he put a whole list of stuff. Adulterers, liars, cheaters, all manner of stuff. And he says, at one time, were such as those were. But we have been washed in the blood, and we are now justified by the blood of Jesus Christ. But let me say this, that God desires that all men should come to repentance and receive the Lord Jesus Christ, and thereby making peace with God. What do you mean, preacher, peace with God? Are you trying to suggest that I'm in a battle against God? Let me say this. If you have Christ, you're fighting against God. Let me tell you, Jesus declared, you either for me or you're against me. He took away the middle road as he was speaking to one of the churches, the seven churches. He said there to the church there in the latter age. He said, I would rather you be hot or cold. But you're lukewarm, and I'll just spew you out. God has, there is no place for being ambiguous. You're either for it or you're against it. Even when you put off your decision, when the preacher preaches and he opens the doors.
Animals in all of his family, and just the same way that ark, that big wooden ship was lifted up in that water. That's the same way that Jesus Christ one day was lifted up on that wood. The same way that the people found salvation being inside of the ark. That's the same way that Jesus Christ was being lifted up on that cross. You can find salvation. Same thing with Moses. The serpents were killing the people. Again, a good description of the devil. The serpents were killing the people. And God said, tell Noah to do a bronze stick. And Moses just lifted it up. And he said, anybody that looks to this bronze serpent, you will be saved. But you have to look up. You have to look up. If you want to be saved, You have to look up. And you know what? I was telling you, if I told you you want to be healed, just look up. And people were not looking up. People didn't want to be saved. People didn't want to be healed. People didn't care. And Moses said, this is salvation. Look up. It's the same thing when Jesus died on the cross. God said, look up to my son. Look up.
Just to find what we've lost. We need to get back to the basics of life.
The heart is good. Because Jesus has given you the strength to defeat.
Faith that is fervently grounded.
Everybody bow your heads and close your eyes. The Word of God says that Jesus became flesh, so that he can give you and me salvation. He knows you're hurting. He knows you're tempted. He knows you have addictions. But Jesus Christ, in flesh, overcame it. Overcame flesh. Overcame the law. Defeated death and defeated the flesh. And today, he wants to give you eternal life. Eternal life. That means the moment that you die, you begin to live. This is not life here. Life is when you die, and Jesus gives you a new beginning. If you want to have a new beginning now, you can have it. You just got to accept Jesus in your heart. Jesus said that you have to confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ rose up from the dead, and you shall be saved. So if you want to accept Jesus, this is the day of salvation for you. Right now we're doing it like Moses. We're lifting up that cross. And we're saying, look up and you shall be saved. You want to be saved? Repeat these words with me.
I want you to be the King and the Lord of my life. I want your will to be done and not my will. And the day I die, I go to heaven. Forgive me of my sins. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. The Word of God says that the moment you accept Jesus in your heart, your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life forever. Now your challenge today is to continue to walk in the path of God and to start living the life that Jesus has commanded you to do.
Of life, a heart that is pure and a love.